All right.
Well, this is part four. I never thought I'd make it to part four, but truth be told, we might even have to make it part five. But things should speed up a little bit now because I'm going to do some 750 millers. And they need four squirts each. And if I don't lose concentration, I get to do this pretty quickly. So the other thing I was getting back to talking about, my ancestors. And the very reason I got back to talking about my grandfathers was because as I was walking out this evening, sneezing my guts out, I still looked at the stars. And to me, the stars, well, apart from the moon, but the stars are pretty much one of the biggest mysteries. I mean, we have our scientific explanation for them. I know, we accept that as the gospel, that they're other suns with other planets revolving around them. I don't accept that for 1 second. Yeah, I used to, until I looked into it. Until I really, really looked. And you look any video evidence that you can find, any visual evidence. I mean, every night I just love looking at this one particular star. It's off to our north here, but obviously in the southern hemisphere, we don't get to see Polaris. It's too far away. Not because we're in a different hemisphere and it's disappeared over the curvature, it's just too far away. Oh, that is still nastily dirty. You know what I should do? Just fucking use it anyway. Part of my Frenchly type of English. I've got these old bottles here that been through the friggin' dishwasher, they're sanitized. So, whatever dirt comes with them, it's going to be part of that bottle. And that is part of being on Earth. Earth is dirt. We are dirt. So, I mean, I like to make nice clean beer, but can you imagine how the Egyptians, they built their pyramids feeding the slaves beer? How the fuck did they sanitize their bottles? Their technology must have been pretty fucking good if they had to, like, go through all these great lengths to sanitize everything. Where everybody died of food poisoning. So I don't think your beer bottles have to be that freaking sanitized. As long as what you start with is pretty good, everything else will take care of itself. I actually haven't had a bad one yet. I've been doing this for a while and I've taken a few risks here and there. And the only bad thing that happened was what happened today is because I put some of these little stubbies right at the back of the fridge and they got frozen. The only bad thing was, is when I cracked them open, there was no fizz or head at all. But the beer was nice and cold and had little icicles in it and still tasted great. So that's the worst that has happened with my brewing success in these last couple of years when I started up again. So I think it's worth taking a few risks here and there. For the sake of beer. So getting back again. Sorry. I got really sidetracked there. Stars and ancestors. Didn't see that coming, did you? Ancestors. Ancestors. And I was getting back also to the near-death experience thing I was talking about before as well. Since I've had a few. When you die, or, you know, leave your body and go into the heavenly realm, I'm going to call it that because that's what it is. I can tell you for a fact, it is the most beautiful, orgasmically joyous place you can be. But when you get there and you look into her eyes and you see the disappointment, you know you have to come back and do what you came here to do. You just know. There's no two ways about it. You're like, okay. You don't even get the chance to say, sorry, yes, I'll do it. You just know. And you get sent back. Unless you've done what you came here to do, in which case all your family is there. All the ones shrouded from you. You know they're there, but they're shrouded. You can feel the energy and the love coming from them. You can look into the eyes of your mother. But you usually don't remember it. I've had three opportunities where I've remembered it. I was gifted with the memory. Twice it only came back to me because I dreamt about it again afterwards, but once I remember vividly. Wasn't supposed to. They have this ability where they block it from your memory. Because it's too great for us to carry on with. If we remember it and come back here, we no longer want to be here. We want to be back there. That's why they block it, for our own good. And so I'm apologizing in advance for telling you this, because you don't want to go there. If you're watching this, then you're obviously part of the reason why I'm still here and you are still here, because we have a task to do. And our task is very important. It's not to exist in heaven. It is to make heaven exist here on earth. That is our most important task. And make sure your beer doesn't overflow. Much easier to do on these long necks, but it takes a bit longer to film. Didn't overflow. Job completed. But then you're gonna do another one. It's a big task trying to make heaven on earth. Which is why, coming back in a roundabout sort of way to why I thought about my grandfathers while I'm looking out at the stars tonight. And I'd love to be able to edit videos and put in this thing about from the Lion King where all I can remember is Mufasa. Because I am your father. And the stars are the great kings of the past. To me, that was the most profound line in that movie. You see the pig running around. I think they're great fiery balls of gas. And my partner, my wife, she turns around and says, oh, that's so funny because that's the truth. And I'm like, I don't know if it actually is. What about if Mufasa is right? That they are the great kings of the past. That these balls of light shimmering and shining and changing colours constantly are the great kings of our past, our ancestors. And all the clouds of stars you see around them are their family, their constellation, their never-changing bodies in heaven. I know it's a bit far out there. It sits on the side of superstition and myth and all the rest. But why do we call all the great wandering stars after gods? Why do they all have names to begin with? Why do we have names? And then I think of my grandparents, great people. Great people. Hard workers of hard land who eked out an existence. Good people for good children so that I could come along and all I want is to find a good bit of land and make a good existence and yeah, I sort of got duped in this life. And then my parents got duped in this life. Economic collapse. All this bullshit they do to steal the wealth office. How many people do you know have lost their farms? It used to be farming was one of the most greatest things you could do and be encouraged to do. But nah. Not since other people can see ways of making wealth off your land if they can starve you off it and then sell it to the fucking Chinese or somebody. Not that I've got anything wrong with Chinese people. This is how they do it. This is how they steal the wealth. How they control the world. Why would anybody want to control the world? Are you a fucking psychopath? Mr. Rockefeller? I believe you are. I believe you are the epitome of a fucking psychopath. Do you know what we do to psychopaths? We throw them off a cliff. A really, really high one. Because they serve no purpose to the goodness of the people of the Mother Earth. So, you can either stop hoarding the wealth and become part of the heaven on earth that it's meant to be. But if you are still profiting from every oil spill, from every natural disaster, from every war, from all this destruction, making all your profits from that, then I can guarantee you 100% your fruit will be sour, or your descendants will suffer, and you will have no escape from eternal hell, and you have no idea, no idea. You will find out. You have the chance to redeem yourself, to become a saint, to become a star in heaven that we will forever look up to and say, there is another great light in heaven shining down on us who did so much good. That is what you want to do. You want to do that. All of you people with the opportunity to help others. That is what you want to do. Believe me. Playing these childish mind games, thinking that the accumulation of wealth is real, when it all exists up in here. Believe me, when I was a child, I used to play a lot of computer games and thought it was great accumulating all this wealth. But it's all imaginary. It's no different in reality. No different. You think you're winning, you're just a fucking child playing fucking childish games. And causing human misery at the same time. And gloating about it. If the wages of sin was really death, you probably wouldn't feel so bad. But death is only a escape from that pathetic fucking pus-riddled body you're living in. There is no death in the eternal scale of who you really are. There is no death. There's no escape. That's why I don't fear death the slightest little bit. You know, you come and do me, all you're really going to do is make me famous, so thank you. Just as you've done every single time. You take out somebody who stands up to you, JFK, Gaddafi. You make them look like, well, you didn't do it with JFK. Everybody knows he was a fucking saint. He was standing up against your bloody pathetic false economy that you used to enslave us all. And tried to rid you. We'll find a way. We'll find a way to get rid of you. Parasites. And we will do it with thought and love in our hearts. To care for what's really important. Our Mother Earth. Nothing. Nothing is more important than that. And if I have to sacrifice my living flesh and blood into her to cure her, to be part of the resurrection of eternal life of the Mother Earth. Do your best. Because either way, you lose, we win. We cannot lose. Yous are fucked. Yous have done your time. You've done too much time playing your fucking childish games, thinking accumulating wealth is a way of winning and controlling and doing it with death and torture and rape. You are fucking villains of the worst kind. And karma. She's a bitch. You can live by your creed. You can knock off people who try and stand up to your creed. But eventually, a Creedence Clearwater revival will begin. Still the rain kept falling, falling on my ears. And I wonder, still I wonder, who'll stop the rain? You know what the right thing to do is? Stop any human suffering anywhere. Spread the wealth. Do what's right. Build up proper food producing communities. I can help you with that. I know all about aquaponics, aquaculture, water filtration, hemp production. Stop raping the earth. She is watching, she's feeling, she's listening to every little thing, and it's all been written down. And if you ain't part of the solution, you're part of the problem. Now, why would you waste your entire lives, generations after generations of accumulating all this wealth, without being part of the solution? That you belong to, that we all belong to, that belongs to all of humanity, all of humankind, to the entire earth. Why are you so selfish? Because I can assure you, it's selfishness. It is one of the most lonely, lonely, lonely for all eternity of the deadly sins. Redeem yourself now. Do everything you can to improve the situation. Sins of your generations may be forgiven. I certainly wouldn't. I think what you have done is fucked up. What you have done in Palestine. Germany. Forgiveness in my heart, but not for that sort of shit. Who am I to judge? I don't even want to mention the atrocities that I know about, simply because reliving them in my head is not good for my mental health. But I know what you have done. Everything is written in the Akashic records of our Mother Earth. And not a single thought, crime, torture, nothing is unrecorded. And every last thing is recorded. And if you don't redeem yourselves now while you still have a chance, then God help you.